Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Histories of Hymns, Stories of Songs. Today, we'll look at the contemporary classic Christmas song, Mary Did You Know? The song's stirring melody, thought-provoking lyrics, and dramatic bridge have made it a very popular choice for recording artists. It's also one of my personal favorite contemporary Christmas songs. But it took several years after the lyrics were first written before it found a musical home and the first recordings took place. With that, let's dive into how Mary Did You Know came to be the song it is today. The conception of Mary Did You Know began in my resident state of Virginia, at Thomas Road Baptist Church on the campus of Liberty University in Lynchburg. In fact, Thomas Road Baptist is responsible for founding Liberty University, initially called Lynchburg Baptist College, in 1971. This ended up being a banner year for Thomas Road Baptist, as it is also when they began their version of a Broadway musical-style Christmas program entitled The Living Christmas Tree, in which the singers stood on risers imitating a Christmas tree. Nowadays, the show is entitled The Virginia Christmas Spectacular. In 1984, preparations had begun for The Living Christmas Tree. Church member and virtually unknown singer-songwriter Mark Lowry was asked to write the program. At first, Mark's script was fairly indicative of a typical Living Christmas Tree show, popular Christmas songs interspersed with complimentary dialogue. At some point, however, Mark had a conversation with his mother about Mary, the mother of Jesus. She was contemplating Mary's own thoughts and said, "You know, if anyone knew Jesus was virgin-born, it was Mary, and her silence at the cross is proof, I think, that her story was indeed true." Suddenly, questions about Mary's personal journey that first Christmas night flooded Mark Lowry's mind. If he was able to sit down and have coffee with Mary, what kind of questions would he ask her? That idea became the inspiration for much of the dialogue for that Living Christmas Tree program in 1984. Afterward, Mark knew he had the lyrics of a song formed, but he struggled to find someone to write music that would complement the lyrics. In 1988, he became a member of the Gaither Vocal Band, a group founded by well-known gospel singer Bill Gaither. The band changes singers often, with artists leaving to work on solo careers and new and old artists replacing them. Lowry was the group's baritone from 1988 to 2001, and his comedic antics in between songs were very popular with audiences. Gospel music songwriter Buddy Green went on tour alongside the Gaither Vocal Band in 1991, and it was on a tour bus one weekend that Mark shared the lyrics of Mary Did You Know with Buddy to see if he'd like a crack at writing the music for it. Buddy took it home, and in 30 minutes, he had it. On Monday morning, Buddy called Mark and sang the music he had composed. As soon as he heard it, Mark knew that the music fit the lyrics perfectly and began making plans to produce the song. Fellow member of the Gaither Vocal Band, Michael English, had the privilege of laying down the first recording of Mary Did You Know. It had an unfortunate release date of January 1st, 1992. However, that didn't stop the song from becoming an instant hit. The song really gained international acclaim when it was recorded by Kenny Rogers and Winona Judd for Rogers' 1996 Christmas album, The Gift. As I was researching for this video, one element I found that surprised me was the contingent of harsh critics of the song out there. I mean, certainly just about every contemporary Christmas song is going to have groups of people who just don't like it for one reason or another. I mean, Christmas Shoes is often disliked because of its seemingly melodramatic and depressing narrative. Some people complain about the cheesiness and overuse of synthesizer in Wonderful Christmas Time, although those are both reasons why I actually like it. But don't get me started on songs like Last Christmas and Baby It's Cold Outside. But the critics of Mary Did You Know don't attack it because of any kind of personal music preferences. Rather, they take issue with what they deem is biblical illiteracy. See, they take the lyrics at face value, reasoning that, of course, Mary knew that the child inside her was the Son of God. And yes, certainly, Mary was told by the angel Gabriel that the child she conceived will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. his kingdom will never end. So, did she literally know that when she kissed her little baby, she kissed the face of God? Well, yes. But I think that Mark Lowry's lyrics were not meant to be taken literally. I think the questions asked of Mary in the song are rhetorical questions, meant to make us, the listeners, think and remember the reason Jesus came to earth that first Christmas, that he is not just a baby in a manger, but the incarnate Son of God that came to deliver us from our sins. If Lowry were to have written a more literal song, perhaps the title would have been, "Mary, Could You Possibly Have Comprehended?" Not quite as poetic, in my opinion. "Mary, Did You Know?" has now been recorded professionally over 400 times by Christian and secular artists alike, such as Clay Aiken, Pentatonix, Carrie Underwood, and Dolly Parton. CeeLo Green's version was used in the 2014 film Son of God, produced by Roma Downey and taken from the popular miniseries The Bible. But it's a lesser-known version that I'd like to share with you in this video, arranged by David Wright for the barbershop quartet The Gas House Gang. In a typical barbershop quartet, you have, from bottom voice to top, bass, baritone, lead, and tenor. The lead is called so because he typically has the melody, the part you hear the most prominently. But in this version, take notice that it's the bass part in the lower right-hand corner of the screen that has the melody the majority of the time, which ascends all the way up to a high A-flat in the bridge, and it adds some great dramatic tension. It's a big part of why this is my favorite arrangement of this beautiful song. Enjoy.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know
that your
Mary,
baby
did you know
would save Ooh. Our sons and daughters?
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you this child that you delivered will soon deliver you?
Mary, did you know that your
baby boy
would give sight to the blind man?
Mary, did you know? Your baby boy has walked where angels trod.
And when you kiss your little baby,
you've kissed the face of God. Mary, did you know?
Did you know
your baby boy could wind and thunder?
Oh, Mary, did you know?
Did you know that your baby boy would do such deeds of wonder?
Such wonder.
The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will speak the praises of the Lamb.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation?
One day rule the nation.
you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great
Thank you so much for watching and listening. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like or a comment, and if there's a hymn or song that you would like featured in a future video, please let me know that in the comments. Thanks again, and God bless.